The SAT was yesterday, and it was a mess. It was my first SAT, and probably my last before, college admission crap. And, nope. I've said it already, but my bag was more prepared than I was. I did study a bit, like a little. I mean, but it didn't really help because, I kind of forgot the math that I had taken before to take the SAT, obviously, because I'm not holding on to it. And I don't do an equation every single day. They tell you not to come out with any of the information on like the questions and everything. I didn't even see half of the test. Like I'm obviously not gonna do that. When I say I didn't see half of the test, I didn't get to it. So I've never been, an aficionado. Is that the word? I think that's the word. On timing, times test, I always take all the time I can. I'm smart, but I need time. I need time to be smart. I mean, like, I did take practice tests and everything like that. I didn't have a tutor or anything, but, yeah. And then there was this guy in front of me. In his defense, he had a really cool last name. I won't say it, but it was really nice. It was a really cool last name. I wish I had it. But he would not stop judging me, like, because, okay, I take a long time to bubble in answers too, so the odds were against me, obviously. And so at the 5-minute mark, I would start bubbling in C because, I'm not just gonna try to leave things blank. So I would start bubbling in C, and then here he comes. Like, I can almost, like, I started just predicting when it was gonna happen, because each time he would just do that, that cool guy stretch, like that, and I can see you. I know what I'm doing. I know I'm a failure. Okay, I know that you finished, okay? Like, it's fine. It's cool. And he would just keep watching me, like, if you're ever in an SAT situation and you see someone struggling, do not stare at them. They have enough problems, okay? Like, what are you doing? What are you doing? See, I normally do better in the English parts. So I didn't think that it was gonna be terrible, but the reading is the first section, and I didn't get to at least like 15 questions. Yeah. The writing section, I'm really good at writing. Writing is my favorite. And I didn't get to some of those questions too, and I was just like, what are you doing, Molly? Like, stop it. Yeah, it was awful. And yeah, so there's that. And then the math, no calculator. Some of it was fine, some of it was okay. And then I didn't fill in any of the student responses. Maybe two, but I think maybe. Well, actually, I don't even think I got to the student responses in the note calculator. So those are blank. But I felt a little bit better because two people that I did know were in my testing situation. Like, they were in my room, and they were some of the nice people at the old school that I went to. And they made me feel a lot better because, you know, I was going to a high school that, you know, was in the county, and, you know, I didn't know anybody. Like, so I knew that a lot of, like, some people from my old school would probably be there because they weren't testing at that school. So, you know, but when we finished the no calculator section, I turned back to one girl that I knew, and she was just like, "I didn't know any of that." Like, she mouthed it to me, and I was just like, you know, like, but I mean, it made me feel better. Like, it gave me some hope because, like, I mean, when you're taking the SAT, you think that you're in your own bubble, and you think, like, everyone else is just like, oh, like, everyone knows what they're doing. I don't know this, I'm an idiot. Like, or at least that's what I think because, well, that's me. And, yeah, so, I mean, a lot of people are confident about themselves and, you know, they're like all entitled and they're just like, oh, I'm the smartest person I know, you know, I'm gonna apply to all these colleges and get in and blah, blah, blah. But, you know, there's always the, like, the humble effect, the humble aspect that, people like to see in your character. I'm not saying be down on yourself or anything, but take it down a notch, you know, like, but, I don't know. I'm just saying, I needed more time. I really did. But I mean, it's fine. Like, I'm not too worried about it. Like, I don't know. I'm not the most worried about it. Like, I'm trying not to worry, but because I know that my grades are good enough to get me where I want to go. I'm only applying to four colleges, and one of them is just a community college, which nothing wrong with community colleges. It's just it's not my top of where I want to go. But, you know, I mean, it doesn't matter to me if I end up there. You know, who cares? And it's cheaper anyways. And I'm not rich, but I don't know. This one guy that I knew, he didn't have a calculator. And if you're watching this, I'm so sorry, man. Like, okay, but that's the thing. I came prepared. Like, I'm kind of like the mom of any situation, like, or I try to be really prepared. And I packed two backup calculators. Hold on, I think I have what I packed right here. I packed two admission tickets, like two admission tickets, just in case. I mean, like, yeah. And then I packed two packs of pencils, if anybody forgot anything. And then I packed erasers and a sharpener. And then I packed backup erasers. And then I packed backup pencils. And then I packed backup batteries. And then I packed the calculator for the batteries. And then I packed two different calculators, not, you know, the fancy calculators, but I'm sure the guy was very grateful, at least. So, then I packed for myself these pencils, and my mom got me these pencils, And you know, she's very eccentric. And I was very grateful for them because they looked like they were gonna work. But I started writing with one, and one was very dull because they have like hard to break lead, and so I had to switch to these because these were a lot easier to bubble. So that took away a bit of my time, which sucked. And then I brought a watch, good cheap little watch. And that was it, I'm pretty sure. No, and then I brought snacks. But I didn't eat my snacks. Like I did everything wrong. I didn't sleep the night before. I couldn't sleep. I could never sleep before big occasions. I didn't eat breakfast. We got breakfast. I couldn't eat it. My stomach was upset. I brought snacks. Didn't eat the snacks during the breaks because I couldn't. I couldn't. Yeah, I mean, I contributed in a way to this potential failure, but I'm just gonna say, like, I never ate breakfast in school, and I never slept well. I've never slept well, and I still performed very well. So, I mean, I know it's a statistic that you need to eat breakfast and sleep and do all this, and I'm sure it helps. But it never really affected anything for me. I mean, probably affected mental health a bit. But yeah, I mean, I was stressed out, but like, I don't know. So yeah. And then the essay prompt, like, okay, I do well in writing, or yeah. I mean, I do pretty well in writing. Writing is my favorite, and it's what I want to do with life. And when I saw the prompt, I was almost at my breaking point, like, 'cause, you know, I was just like, is this it? Is this it? Because, you know, that was like my shot. That's what I thought, you know. And it was so boring. Like, I'm not gonna talk about it because, you know, you're not allowed to talk about it. Speaking of that, there are so many memes. I mean, I know that people, you know, do illegal things and everything, but they were so funny to look at yesterday when I was so down about everything. I don't know. They're hilarious. Props to you people that don't care about the law. So, two different people that were in my room were using mechanical pencils. And I know that that's not like a big deal to some people, but it's a big deal to me because that's a rule. Like, you know? And to me, that gives them some edge. Like, because I write so much faster with mechanical pencils. I write better with mechanical pencils. Kind of. And just the fact that they got to use them, I mean, these people finished a lot faster than me, in each section. And maybe, like, you know, well, I know that they were probably gonna finish faster anyway, but I'm upset about it. I wish I could have used mechanical pencil. You'll notice I didn't put any foundation on, and you know, I normally don't. And that's just to show you that I'm not perfect. And I'm sure you know that. Because I most likely failed the SATs. Yeah. You know, I'm obviously not perfect because I have a candle lit. And you can't see it. You can't see it. Like, that's, you know, the whole YouTuber aesthetic thing. You can't see my candle. It's lit. It smells good. Can't smell it. I mean, technology's not that great yet. You can't smell the candle. It smells good. I have a Christmas tree up. Snow globe out. It's Christmas as heck in here. 2 wicks just went out. that's it. Haven't. Probably should have introduced myself. You know, I'm the worst. Okay, that's it. Like and subscribe if you want to. You don't have to. Freedom and everything. Okay, so have a great day. Don't take the SAT, unless you're a genius.